This video was created for the Clearwater Public Library System.
Family supervision and participation are strongly encouraged and definitely required for younger children.
Welcome to Posada Party 2020.
Hi, I'm Miss Jill, also known as Jill Jackson and Sister Earth.
And I'm Nicole.
We're here today with a fabulous Posada Party.
Today, we'll be making a festive skee-ball game,
decorating and opening mini holiday pinatas,
creating with the only kind of snow you'll see in Florida this year,
and I'll share my recipe for spiced holiday salt clay dough. But wait, there's more!
We've also got some printable crafts, including poinsettia garlands and decor,
a Posada coloring page I've put together,
this lovely advent wreath,
and show you how to make and decorate a paper plate tree. You may want to print out copies of the printables now. They're available in the video description below and also at the instructions page at sistereearth.net. Each of the printouts are available in black and white if you'd like to color or print them. Or you can print out the pages I've already colored in and get right to crafting. If you've got a craft kit, hold on until we get started before tearing into the candy.
Every single piece of the kit has a purpose, and it won't be long until we let you know what the purpose is.
What you'll need: glue, tape, scissors, markers, and a stapler. Optional: stickers, glitter, paint, and more.
No craft kit? No problem. As always, I'll provide full instructions to make these crafts even if you don't have a craft kit, with things you probably already have around the house.
It's not time to open our mini snowman pinatas just yet, but we've put a little bit of extra candy in every craft kit. The loose candy in the kit, not the candy in the mini pinatas. And if it's alright with the adults in your life, it's probably a good idea to ask for permission. You can dig in and eat some candy now.
A quick history of Posada, according to kids.botanica.com.
Las Posadas is a Christmas festival. The name is Spanish for the inns. The festival is celebrated for 9 nights, beginning on December 16th and ending on Christmas Eve. Las Posadas recalls the journey Joseph and Mary made to Bethlehem before the birth of Jesus. When they arrived in Bethlehem, they could not find a room at an inn. Mary and Joseph were forced to stay in a stable where Jesus was born.
Each night of Las Posadas begins with a procession of children. They often carry lit candles and images of Mary and Joseph. The procession goes from place to place asking if there's room for them to stay.
The hosts say no, but often provide refreshments. The procession is finally allowed entry at the last house, where there's a piñata filled with candy and toys. The same procession occurs every night except for the last night.
The Posada on the 24th is the most festive and is followed by the midnight Christmas Mass.
That's awesome!
So interesting!
So let's get started! Once upon a time, Miss Jill and Nikki were putting up holiday decorations all around the house.
Suddenly, they came across one they did not recognize from years past.
A festive red sleigh. They didn't know it yet, but they were about to embark on a very special journey.
To the North Pole!
Alaska! In order to create magic to make the sleigh fly, they had to answer a series of riddles,
all designed to help them share holiday joy.
The riddles would present themselves one by one as the pair began their quest to return Santa's sleigh.
Riddle number one. What rhymes with Posada and breaks open to reveal sweets and treats?
Piñata!
Decorate one.
We'll be opening our mini snowman piñatas later in the video.
But first, let's get to decorating them so they can get to drying. This is your mini snowman pinata. There's a small condiment cup on top. The small cup contains googly eyes, a carrot nose, and buttons to make a coal mouth. There's also a red ribbon inside to be glued around the brim of the hat. Carefully remove the top of the hat and place the googly eyes and other items aside for now. We'll get right to gluing our crepe paper on. Fold your crepe paper and use scissors to notch the paper all the way across. Unfold the paper and cut it into 4 or 5 inch strips. Using school glue, add a line of glue across the top non-cut edge. I like to add the glue to several strips at a time. So, starting at the bottom of your pinata, we're going to add these strips all the way around. Work your way all the way around the pinata and then work up. If you don't have a craft kit, you can make a mini pinata with sour cream or cottage cheese containers, or wash out beverage and condiment containers from a restaurant. Use your imagination. There's our snow for the snowman. I'm going to throw these jingle bells right into the hat and put my little hat top right back on. Make sure it's closed well. And now it's time to add our snowman face. I've turned my googly eyes and my carrot nose and buttons upside down so that I can add a dot of blue to the back of each one. Now set your pinata aside to dry. It won't take long, and we'll be opening it up later in the video.
Rule number two. What combines snowmen, snowballs, and skiing?
Why, it must be snowman ski ball.
Create a game with all three.
This is so much fun.
Snowman Ski Ball. Empty out your craft kit box and put everything aside. I've already cut off part of the flap and taped it inside the box. This will act as our lift when we're playing ski ball. Here's a quick look at where we're going with this. So grab your biggest cup and put some glue on the bottom rim. Place it into the box as close to the bottom edge as possible. Now we'll take our medium cup and repeat the process for the middle of our snowman. Inside your craft kit, you'll find a Ziploc bag full of pipe cleaners, googly eyes, and the cutest little hats. Remove the pipe cleaner arms and cut them one at a time. Cut a couple of inches off the end. And turn the cut piece into a V. And wrap the fingers around the arm, just like this. Now I'll create an elbow. And there's arm number one. We're going to repeat this process for the other side. And it's time to glue each arm into place. Next comes the red bow tie. Put a little dot of glue on. Put that right over that snowman midsection. And we're on to the head. You'll have two condiment containers. Put two of your cotton balls in there. That'll be our snow for our face. And I'm going to glue this edge down. Make sure and get your cotton balls underneath and push them right down to the bow without popping your bow up. You may have to reposition your bow. These hats. Do you not love these little hats? How cute are they? A little glue on the back. And glue it right into place. Now for the top of our snowman head. We're going to put some glue on the back rim right there, and try and center that on this bottom cup. That's where our ping pong ball can bounce into. Now it's time to add our face, two googly eyes, a carrot nose, a cool mouth, and let's add a jingle bell and some cotton ball snow. This is the base for our snowman ski ball, and now it's time to decorate. You can add stickers, glitter, anything you'd like in the background. Let's make them festive and fun. Now we'll need a ramp for our ping pong ball. I've placed this ornament on the flap of the box to show you about the width. You want about 1 inch between some popsicle sticks. So we'll lay out two sticks in a straight line, and then we'll continue that line all the way up to the top of the box there. Make sure not to go past your flap. You'll want to be able to close your box when you're not playing. Hold them down for just a moment and they'll stick. Now we'll reinforce these seams with another popsicle stick. Make sure that your flap can still bend for the lift. Give it a try. Hop, it went right in. Now it's time to decorate our flap and allow this to dry thoroughly. Once it has, remove the sticker from your box. You can print out the snowman ski ball worksheet. There's one in color already colored in for you, or there's a blank one for you to color in. And using just a few dots of glue, we'll go ahead and attach that to the front of our snowman ski ball box. Feel free to add stickers, glitter, paint, anything else you'd like on the outside of the box. This won't take long to dry at all. If you'd like to keep score when you're playing, the bottom cup is 5 points, 10 points for the middle, and 25 for the top. Snowman Ski Ball Alternative. If you don't have a craft kit, you can make Snowman Ski Ball out of a shoebox or another box that you find. Here's one I made where I cut off the lid and taped it back in the middle, leaving one of the natural flaps on the box to be our lift into the snowman ski ball. I've gone ahead and duct taped the outside as well for strength, and I'll decorate this just the same as the other. Have fun with it. Have I mentioned how much I love these little hats? Here I've printed out a smaller version of the Snowman Ski Ball worksheet to attach to my shoebox. And there we go. Snowman Ski Ball without a craft kit. Can there ever be enough stickers? You can adjust the angle of your ramp and your lift to get different effects with the ball. I think that's up a little high, lower it a little, and there we go.
What's the only kind of snow we'll get this year in Florida?
Tater snow!
Use it two ways to make holiday art.
Tater snow scene. This is the Posada Snowman coloring page I've put together. You may want to use this for this craft. And this is tater snow, also known as instant mashed potatoes. We're going to use our tater snow as glitter. So first, put down some glue, any place that you'd like there to be some tater snow. I'm putting some down on the ground, but I also want some on the top of my trees, around the top of my star. You can also draw your own page for this and make all kinds of projects with tater snow at home. I'm going to use my finger to spread out the glue anywhere I'd like some tater snow to be. Now this is important. You only want to use about 2/3 of your tater snow. Save about 1/3 of that tater snow for the next project. So go ahead and sprinkle some of your tater snow down over your glue just like you do if you were putting down some glitter. I sure don't want to miss any spots. I've still got plenty of tater snow left. Carefully, I'll dump off any excess onto a paper plate and set this aside to dry. And I'll even put the rest of my tater snow right back into the container. Tater mini snow globes. On the printable holiday ornaments and mini snow globes page, you'll find the mini snow globe inserts. You can color in your own or cut out the one that I've colored in for you. Cut a small split in the bottom middle where indicated and fold up the flaps on either side. Now fold it in the middle on the line and do a good job of burnishing or pressing down all of your edges. Now we'll want to apply some glue to these bottom flaps and glue them to the underside of the lid, right in the middle. Put a small dot of glue in this upper corner and squeeze together for just a moment. There's the bottom of our snow globe. Make sure you only have about a third of the mashed potatoes in here. And carefully place your insert and lid together, snap it closed, and there is your mini snow globe.
Sculptures that can be baked and smell just like holiday cookies.
Spiced holiday salt clay dough.
Mix up a batch.
Spiced holiday salt clay dough. You'll find a printable spiced holiday salt clay dough recipe worksheet both in the description below and in the instructions page at sisterearth.net. I'm going to make two batches of the half recipe. One will be in the natural color and the other I'll mix up in red. I'm going to use some cups to stand up some Ziploc bags and gather my ingredients. For this recipe, you'll need flour, salt, and water. First, I'll carefully add the flour to each bag. Next, I'll add the salt. And I'll slowly add the water to just one bag that I'm working on. Make sure and have your pumpkin spice or some cinnamon or ginger to add very shortly. Now try to seal the bag tightly, getting out as much air as you can. And mix, mix, mix. Now I didn't have my bag sealed well enough. Did I say mix, mix, mix? If you've got it, this is a good time to add pumpkin spice. You can also add cinnamon or ground ginger or any spice that you have around that you think might smell nice in your dough. Also, add a little bit more water if you need to. This dough is on the drier side, but you can always add a little more if you don't feel like the dough is coming together. I'll set this bag aside and let the dough rest and add some water to the other bag. And it's time to, guess what? Mix, mix, mix. We'll add our pumpkin spice, a little water, blend a little. And now, if you've got it, and this is optional, you can use a few drops of food coloring. I added about 10 drops of red to the dough. Mix, mix, mix. I've grabbed a cutting board as the dough will need to be kneaded for just a few moments. This comes together pretty quickly now. The zip bag really helps to contain the mess. You can fold the dough into the middle and continue pushing down with your palms. Form the dough into a ball and allow it to rest. Gingerbread man ornament. For this ornament, we'll need to go ahead and flatten the dough. I went to about 1/3 inch thick. I'm using a cup as a rolling pin. And I'm just going to cut out my gingerbread man using a cookie cutter. I'll remove the excess dough. And using a straw, I'll create a place to put an ornament hanger or tie a ribbon to hang this after it's baked. I've got my oven preheated to 250 degrees, and carefully using a spatula, I'll place my gingerbread man on a parchment paper lined cookie sheet. Reindeer ornament. Again, I'll cut out another gingerbread man. Only this time, I'm going to use it upside down and make a reindeer. I'll show you how after it's baked. Candy cane ornament. For this ornament, I'll roll out 2 logs or snakes. Don't worry if you get a break. Dip your finger in water, repair the spot, and continue to roll. One of my logs will be the natural color and the other will be red. I'm simply going to wrap them together, pinch the ends, and voila, a candy cane. Snowman ornament. For this ornament, I'm going to use a cup as a cookie cutter. And I'll roll out a red log to create a frame. I'm using my fingers to pinch the frame against the main part of the ornament so that they stick together. Now I'll make a little carrot nose, and I'm going to use a fork to add some texture to make it look a little bit more like a carrot. It gets a hole for an ornament hanger, and off it goes to the baking sheet. Freestyle tree ornament. For this ornament, I'm going to use a butter knife to cut out the shape of a tree. Remove the excess dough, and again, use a fork to create some texture. Off it goes to the baking sheet. I've preheated my oven to 250 degrees, and I'll bake these ornaments for 2 hours. Allow them to cool completely. I'm going to use some puffy fabric paint to decorate these, but you could also use craft paint or glitter, or mix some food coloring together with glue. Are you starting to see that reindeer now? I thought it would be fun to add a Santa hat to this gingerbread man. And some white glitter paint as the snow on our snowman ornament. I might have gone a little crazy with this. Did I mention I was an artist? I just can't help myself. Now you knew this was going to be Rudolph, didn't you? This tree needs some lights. Almost done now, putting those final touches on. After these have dried completely, probably overnight, I like to seal them with a few quick coats of some clear spray gloss to make the ornaments last longer. Add a ribbon or ornament hanger and they're ready to go on the tree. Printable paper poinsettias. Cut out several pages. You'll want to make a few of these. I like to go ahead and add a dot of glue to the middle of each one. Using the larger piece as a base, add your smaller piece on top. It's good to stagger the leaves. Add a dot of glue to the middle of each of your green pieces, as well as your red. Set the red piece on top of the green, again staggering the leaves. You can add the middle now. Allow them to dry. It only takes 10 minutes or so. They make beautiful greeting cards, or you can fold the bottom, poke a skewer through, and wrap the bottom with tape to make a three-dimensional flower. Printable poinsettia garland. Start by cutting strips of paper and using tape or staples to create circles, adding one link at a time until you have the length of garland desired. Cut out the poinsettias and tape or staple them to your garland. Printable Advent Wreath. This one's pretty simple. You can just cut it out and count down the last few days before Christmas. Add a candle each of the 10 days before Christmas. or glue them all on at once to make a festive wreath. Paper plate trees. For this, you'll need an ornament hanger or a ribbon, scissors, and a paper plate. Cut a spiral into your paper plate to create the tree. Using a hole punch, create a hole and hang it. Cut out the ornaments on the printable holiday ornaments worksheet. Punch a hole towards the top of each one. You can use an ornament hanger or a ribbon. Pick up your tree and, using a hole punch again, place 6 holes on the tree exactly where you'd like to hang your ornaments. Now use the ornament hanger or tie a ribbon through each ornament into your tree, and your tree will be ready to hang.
Snow over there.
Woo-hoo-hoo!
We made it! Santa!
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas! Thank you for returning my sleigh! And thank you all for helping to share holiday cheer! Keep up the good work! Okay, it's almost time to open up the mini snowman pinatas! Let's count down together. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Open the piñatas. Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas and Happy Posada!
And suddenly, they were back home. Thank you. Thank you so much for joining us. This has been so much fun, and we've learned a lot about Posada. We hope that we've given you tons of ideas to keep you creating all winter long.
As always, my friends, happy creating! We're here with the fabulous... And so you know... And so you know... Okay. That's so baby in the bloopers. This video was created for the Clearwater Public Library System.
Thanks so much for watching. Please subscribe for more tips and ideas and visit sisterearth.net for videos, events, and to check out the fine art and children's books available for purchase. As always, happy creating, my friends!